30 minutes for this session. My name is Anand. I'm basically a physician by training, and I've been working in the clinical research industry for around 40 years now, handling the clinical development and the other activities like biometrics and regulatory. I have been fortunate enough to work with a lot of biologics, including biosimilars, in the past few years. So I think it's a great opportunity, and I would like to thank the organizers of BioAsia for giving me this opportunity to speak on this topic. So without wasting much time, I would like to quickly give a preamble. I am sure I think a lot of you are already aware of the importance of biosimilars. We had a wonderful session earlier with senior regulators and others mentioning about how important affordable medicine is for the globe and also especially for India. So from that context, biosimilars are crucial simply because they address a lot of life-threatening medical conditions in the field of healthcare. And India has been a pioneer in even the biosimilars, like in the case of generics. I think just to kind of state the same thing factually, you can see that probably around what the literature says, around 2000 biosimilars actually have been approved in China. Of course, China is kind of a black hole, really. We really don't know what's happening there, at least what I personally understand. I'm not very sure of that number, but then that's what the literature says. The next highest number of biosimilars actually have been approved in India. So we are a pioneer from that perspective. Nearly around 50 biosimilars have been approved in the past many years. And also we had an important guidelines with respect to biosimilar, which was issued on September 15, 2012. So this was after the Europe, which took a lead in issuing biosimilar guidelines and product-specific guidelines with respect to various products in that area. And also, I think I'm sure you would have read in the news that FDA also, in principle, is going ahead with an approval of a first biosimilar for the US market. So Europe probably has approved around 14 to 15 biosimilars, and the US is also making way towards approving the first biosimilar market. So from that context, I think understanding the biosimilar landscape, the Indian guidelines, how different are we, or are we completely aligned to the global guidelines is going to be very important. And myself and my colleague would be addressing the various aspects of these guidelines. What we have planned is that since we are having a very short time, we probably will be just giving you an overview. I think a lot of you are already aware of the guidelines, which is published on the website of CDSCO, and even the other guidelines are available in the net. You can read through. So our intention is not really to read through the guidelines, but only give you an overview, just to tickle your brains, and just to probably, hopefully, before the lunch, you can at least keep yourself awake to ask us some questions. So with that, I would like to invite my colleague who would start the proceedings with the product characterization. So as you know, the biosimilar approval generally follows a stepwise development, which is generally followed with all the drug development. But all the more for biosimilars, this is something which is stressed over and over because that's the sequence which the regulators want the development to happen for various reasons. The product characterization and the bioanalytical methods should proceed preclinical and clinical. So we are also using the same approach during this session. So he would start the session with the product characterization, and I would follow with the preclinical and clinical development aspects of these biosimilars. Thanks.